Hello. Today we are going to talk about the new investigations in black hole physics and cosmology, which is pseudo-fractal geometry of the COVID-19 virus. As being applied to the black hole horizon geometry and also cosmological horizon geometry. So we have seen a lot of COVID-19 photos or pictures on the news, everywhere on the media, on TV, on the newspapers, everywhere. So if you have a look onto this picture here, it contains kind of a big sphere on which there are some smaller kind of spheres one sees another series of spheres being attached, and then consecutively you may think of more and more spheres to be attached to this kind of geometrical shape. So the question is this kind of geometry something which is known in mathematics, which is called a fractal. An example of the fractal in the real world is, for example, a cauliflower, which you eat from time to time for lunch. So the question is, how could we explore some similarity between this COVID-19 geometry and the fractal, possible fractal geometry of a black hole, which is an object under investigations in gravity theory. So here we can see one example of such a such a fractal structure, which you can see that it is split. You have a triangle and you split into it into three pieces, and these pieces, one of these pieces you append with another segments of the line. So you start with, for example, with this line, you then split into three parts, and to another part you simply grow another triangle, and then another triangle you also create here in the middle of the line of the segment which was split into three pieces. And again, this one is split also. And you can continue this up to infinity. There is the notion of a fractal dimension, which applies to this structure, as I have shown previously. It's a limit of some logarithm of the number of, or ratio of the logarithm of the number of n-dimensional cubes. In our case, it was the segment of a line which have side epsilon, which are necessary to cover a fractal. So, and then you have the K number, which is number of steps. And you take the ratio of these two, which are, in fact, the logarithm of the number of n-dimensional cubes to the logarithm of inverse of these sides, which are necessary to cover a fractal. In our example, which in fact was shown on the previous slide, we have four sides necessary to cover a fractal, but originally the number of the segments is three. So you can count that the dimension of this fractal is not one, it's not two, but it's actually 1,26,186. So here you can see it explicitly. So you need you get the number of cubes or segments. It's 4 to the power k. In the first step, it's 4 to 0 of power, so it's just 1. Then there are 4 segments, then 4 squared, 16, etc. As you can see in these pictures here. So you can see that these pictures, first you have one line, and then you have 1, 2, 3, 4 lines, and this is the number of cubes or segments, 4 to the power of 1, and then the next step, each of them you split into 4. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 times 4, which is 16 segments to cover a fractal, etc., under the limit of k going to infinity, dimension is not an integer, but it has a value which is not necessarily integer, it can be a fractional value, which is strange, but it is normal for the fractal structures. Here you can see another example of such a structure, in which you divide a triangle onto another three triangles, a side of a triangle you divide into half, and then you cover with triangles. So in each step, you have three copies of this fractal. And so you see that you can calculate the dimension, which is 1,585. This is your another example in which you have this not as a flat geometry, but it's a geometry which is spatial geometry. So you can count also the fractal dimension, which is slightly different from what you saw already. So this is an example of the Sierpinski triangle. And now we have another example, which is the Manger sponge, where you have a cube. And out of this cube, you make another geometry by removing some inside blocks, and what is remained is 20 cubes in each step of this procedure of dividing the structure. So one cube, then 20 cubes, you can count them, eight in here and eight on the back side, and four, two here and two on the other side. So you can make it in each step the new kind of a structure. So the size of this, the dimension of this structure is not two, it's not three, because it's not fully spatial, it's not fully flat, but it's 2.726. Here you can see this structure again. So now, coming back to our example of COVID-19, it emerges that there is a structure which somehow is alike the COVID-19 geometrical structure, although it's really a fractal which can be counted systematically as a fractal. And this is called a sphere flake, which is a sphere which is first covered systematically by the number of small spheres. And to each of these spheres, as you have seen already on the COVID-19 example, you can have another smaller spheres to actually feed them in, etc., etc. And this result is really a fractal structure, and it is called the sphere flake. You may find it, the animation, on the YouTube. I will not display it at the moment, but you can imagine how it works. You simply have one sphere, then you attach 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 smaller spheres, then again and again. Here you see the next step. So you have this number of spheres growing. So it seems that it looks alike. It was just the COVID-19 structure. Why? This is an explanation. If you look at all this, you may have immediately an explanation why the COVID-19 virus attaches or sticks easily to everything, because it's quite symmetric and it has a kind of a fingers to actually larger, smaller, medium-sized fingers to actually attach, to stick to or cling to other materials, in particular the materials which are a bit rough, like the skin or something like this. It's like a centipede, okay, has hundreds of legs, or just a hairbrush where there are also hundreds of legs, so you may stick easily to your hair with the hairbrush. Okay, let us now look at the stuff mathematically. How does this look like, this sphere flake, in terms of the proper mathematics? So you see that each time you attach another sphere, which has the ratio lambda, which is the next sphere n plus 1, is a smaller one, so the ratio lambda is between 0 and 1, Then you have n as the number of attached spheres in each step. So for example, for the sphere flake, you saw on this example, there were six spheres attached in the step number one, and then the number was growing. So the story is that you may count the effective area of such a fractal structure. So surely this effective area will be larger than the area of the sphere, because you count the surfaces of all these extra spheres. So by simple geometrical series calculations, you may find that this effective sphere has an effective radius which depends on the number of attached spheres and this ratio lambda. So you see that there is some effective radius of the sphere, which is a fractal, but it is not the radius of this, I say, mother sphere, the main sphere on which all this structure started growing. So this R squared effective, since this is smaller than one, must surely be greater than just R, just this first sphere, which actually was taken into account. So you see that this R effective can be written the following way, okay? That it's R 1 plus delta over 2, and delta parameter characterizes the degree of fractality of of this object. So delta is from 0 to 1. So if delta is 0, then we have just a sphere. If delta is 1, we have the most intricate, the most complicated fractal structure for this object. Now coming to black holes. So as you have seen here, the radius of a fractal of the sphere flake is different from the radius of a regular single sphere. And we know from the black hole physics that the black holes in the universe are covered with the sphere, which is called the horizon, to which we actually attach the entropy of a black hole, which is in fact the horizon size, or this horizon sphere size, or it's proportional to the horizon sphere size. And it immediately comes that we may consider the black hole horizon, a kind of a hypothesis which we may put, is that the black hole horizon may have the fractal structure, which is like the sphere flake, or say pseudo fractal COVID. We may consider this. We may consider this different surface area of the horizon and calculate the related entropy of the black hole, which would be the generalization of the Bekenstein entropy or Hawking-Bekenstein entropy of the black hole horizon, which refers to the black hole thermodynamics. As I said, black hole thermodynamics, there is the so-called Hawking radiation, which results naturally in black hole thermodynamics. Simply, these black holes emit the Hawking radiation, which is due to this information which was swallowed by the black hole, it is related to this black hole entropy of being the horizon size. The same procedure as for the black holes, we may then apply for the so-called cosmological horizon, which is the size of the universe or of the observable visible universe, or something which we may attach to according to our knowledge, to our universe. And this cosmological horizon is a sphere which has some size, which we may calculate, and it is the size which we may consider as a radius. So now we may consider the hypothesis that this sphere is not just a sphere, but that it is a fractal structure of this sphere flake, which I presented earlier. So it seems that once one calculates the entropy of such an object, either black hole or a cosmological horizon, one reaches the result which is corrected onto the value of all these, of the surfaces of all these extra spheres which we attached to the main horizon sphere. And this all refers to this parameter delta, which I already told you that it's between 0 and 1. So 0 is just a sphere, and 1 is a maximally intricate, maximally complicated kind of a fractal horizon. So here you see that effective entropy for such a fractal geometry is proportional to the area with some extra value being added related to the delta. So if delta is 0, then it's just a Bekenstein Hawking case. The entropy of a black hole is proportional to the area. Here you can see this entropy being expressed by the smallest bit of information, which is the Planck area. The Planck area is the area of the minimum distance, which is predicted in physics to fulfill the requirements of the theory of general relativity. So here we see that the entropy, the measure of complexity of the universe, is proportional to the Boltzmann constant times the ratio of A of the size of the sphere divided by the Planck area up to the power 1 plus delta 2. So for just for a regular sphere, it is just a over a Planck. But if we have this fractal structure, it has the value which is it's slightly different and for sure larger. So the more spheres we attach to the basic sphere, the more complicated structure, and so the larger entropy. So calculations in physics show that in our universe, the number of information which is calculated within the horizon of the of our universe is 10 to the power 120, which means that we have 1 and 120 zeros. But if we consider this fractal structure or take this fractal structure into account, we have extra delta half more power to be added to the power of 10. So, for example, if we have some maximum maximally intricate geometry of the sphere plate, so all the small spheres are calculated up to infinity. So in fact, in this case, the surface becomes a volume, in fact, then we have the entropy of the universe being enlarged of 60 orders of magnitude. So it means that if one considers just a single sphere, the entropy of the universe, the complexity of the universe is 10 to the power 120. But if we take delta equals to 1, so maximally intricate fractal, then the entropy of the universe is 10 to the power 180, so 180 zeros more. So it means that the entropy grows vastly once one considers this fractal structure. Actually, the whole idea was due to John Barrow, a cosmologist and a Templeton Prize winner, who unfortunately died quite young last year. And he, during the last half year of his life, or a couple of months, 4 months before he died of cancer, he came into that idea and published it in a paper in Physics Letters B, 2020. Actually, John Barrow is also an honorable doctor of University of Szczecin in Poland. Here is a photo which comes from this ceremony, which after this ceremony in 2007 with me. And what actually was the case, quickly after he published his ideas, me and Vincenzo Zalzano from the University of Szczecin, Szczecin Cosmology Group, we have published a paper in which we have actually shown that this fractal structure as being adopted to the size of the horizon of the universe brings us to better fit of such a universe, which is called the holographic universe, the holographic dark energy, brings us to a better fit to the astronomical, to the cosmological data than the standard Lambda CDM model, which is now a canonical model of cosmology. This is very curious that such kind of very, very sophisticated or very, one could say, very complicated, very exotic structure of the horizon may bring better fit to the actual observational data. But this actually happens, which we have shown in the paper published last year. So to summarize, this is an interesting idea, this pseudo-fractal geometry of COVID, or being extended into sphere-flake geometry of COVID-19, that it may fit better the real world. The topic was investigated also by many others, not necessarily only by us, but the message is that sometimes in physics, kind of a, I would say, exotic or crazy ideas may perhaps even lead to the better fit to the observational.